Sun Jian will take the lead. And Yuan Shu shall provide support. We leave before daybreak. Generals, good fortune in battle.
Lord Yuan Shu, I am counting on you. Farewell.
Common swine. You won't be so smug for long.
Alright, so you already know the narration. So I'm going to go right into the Battle Siege Way Gate and take it from there. Alright, so in the last stage, or the last battle, I play as Ma Chao. And I'm going to stay as Ma Chao, but I've unlocked his third and fourth models. So I'm going to show that off. So anyway, here we go, and let's do it. Alright, so the equipment, the weapon, we have a Stallion Spear at level 6. The items, I'm going to add the Wind Scroll. The bodyguards are at 8. The objectives are the same. We have to defeat Li Jue to win or have him retreat. If you want Xiao defeated, if I die, or if the time runs out, we lose. The unit info, pretty much somewhat the same. For the allied forces, you have Yuan Shao and Zheng He, Yuan Shu, Gansun San, Cao Cao and Cao Ren, Sun Jian and Sun Se, and Liu Bei, Guan Yu, and Ma Chao, which is me. Then for Dong Zhuo's forces, you have Li Dui, Li Meng, and Yan Fang, Guo Se, Li Ru, Hua Xiang, and Hu Zhen, and Zhao Sen, Fan Chou and Wang Fang, Nao Fu, Gao Shun, and Li Su. Alright, let's do it. And, same shit we have to do. Main objective. Shit ton of KOs, shit ton of points, and we have to be fucking fast with it. So, let's see what we can do here.
This is a just battle to punish the traitors that ravage this land. All forces, march for Si Shui Gate.
So, we're gonna go and defeat Guo Se first. And the Rat Packs. Alright, there's Guo Se. And Guo Se is down. Alright, there's another fucking Rat Pack. There we go. Alright, now Li Ru.
Even if I send the supplies now, the glory will be all Sun Jian's.
Really?
Do not send the supply convoy out yet.
What the actual fuck? There you go. I was gonna say. Anyway, now that I defeated Li Ru, this is gonna be a really, really interesting stage. Well, part, I should say. But anyway, so Sun Jian seeks provisions, and Yuan Shu won't give him any until, well, in the stage in general, he won't even at all.
We can attack the enemy supply depot from there.
So the only way is to actually defeat Fan Chou and get the supplies that way. So anyway, we'll defeat Wang Fang, and holy shit, did that really take one fucking hit? Anyway, now we'll defeat Fan Chou. There we go.
Supplies. Lord Sun Jian needed some food. Enemy officer defeated.
Behind.
Good. Our food problems are solved. Now we attack Si Shui Gate.
And now the gates will open and Hua Xiang will come out, but Sun Jian's forces will increase. Well, his morale anyway. And there you go. So now I'm going to go around and defeat the following. We'll defeat Li Su, Gao Shun, and Nao Fu. Then we'll go and defeat Hua Xiang, Hu Zhen, and Zhao Shen. But like I said, one step at a time.
Did you think you could break through our forces?
So yeah, in a way, my main goal really at this point is to pretty much, like I said, I need to get a lot of KOs. I don't know if I'm going to be able to pull that off here, but if I do, great. If not, that's fine too. But, shit ton of KOs, shit ton of points, and then, I gotta be quick with it, because, I need to have an average time played of less than 20 minutes. Unlike the first time where I tried to unlock the, second ending and failed, it has to be more. Here, less. And then, when we get to the campaign for Chengdu, we have to have Liu Zhang surrender. So I'm going to have to skip the Battle of Low Castle in order for that to actually happen. Anyway, here's Li Su. Really? There we go. Okay, fuck this. Alright, Li Su's down. I don't know why it took longer than it needed to be. Alright, here's Nao Fu. Alright, he has to quit blocking it like a fucking fortress. Alright, he's down. The gate captain's down. I'm gonna hop over, grab that Musou wine, go up, and then feed Gao Shun, then Hua Xiang's officers, then Hua Xiang, and then let's see what happens. Alright, there's Gao Shun. There we go. Now who's Zhen since he's right here? And it's Hua Xiang as well. But for the fact that we didn't have to worry about Sun Jian retreating, Hua Xiang will not challenge me to a duel. And there's Zhao Shen. He's down. And enemy reinforcements arrive. If you actually, if you're playing the stage for the very first time, and if you haven't unlocked Zhang Liao, then it'll be Zhang Liao. Otherwise, it'll be Tang Min. And I believe in free mode, it'll be Zhang Liao as well. There you go, he's down. Now I'm gonna go and defeat very quickly the other four. I don't know if I'll be able to get the 200 KOs, but I know if I'm quick enough, I'll be able to defeat all four. We'll see, because sometimes Li Dui will retreat very fucking quickly, and then sometimes he'll take a long time. It all depends. Anyway. Yang Fong is down. Defeated. Li Meng is down. Dong Min is down. And I could toy around with him for a bit, but I really don't want. He might just retreat because I just ran into a fucking wall. And that's a win. Alright, well. At least I got. How many KOs did I get? I think I got 199. A lot more than I actually thought I was gonna get. We'll see. Anyway, 7 minutes and 53 seconds. Items, I doubt I got anything good. Yeah, 199 KOs. That's actually not that bad for the fact that I was actually trying. The worthy opponent count is 9. It could be 10. Not 9. Wow. My math is way off right now. 13. It could be 14 in a way, but I don't know why I ran into that fucking wall, but it is what it is. And we have a good 4,078 points. So we're over that 4,000 mark still. So, in a way, the main objective is still there. And that'll be enough to get Ma Chao to rank 6, I believe, and that's it. And there you go. The weapon experience total is 2,728. More than enough to get to level 7, which is now the class 3 weapon, the Silver Stallion. So, that's another class 3 weapon in the books. And now, I'm going to move on to the next one. I don't know who I'm going to play as yet, but anyway. Bodyguards, who cares, they're max. We'll save, and let's continue. Alright, so you know the narration already, so I'm going to skip it and go right into it, but first things first, I'm going to swap out characters, and I believe there are only 5 characters left whose weapon is at level 6. I have Zhuge Liang, Liu Bei, Wang Zhang, Peng Tong, and Yue Ying. So I have those 5, and I'm definitely not playing the stage as Zhuge Liang or Peng Tong, and maybe even Yue Ying. Yue Ying, maybe I would. Let's see here. So I have Yue Ying, Wang Zhang, and Liu Bei. You know what? It's been a real fucking long time since I've played as Liu Bei, and I know it's been even longer with Zhang Fei. But let's play as Liu Bei, despite the fact that I have played the stage as him. So, anyway, he has a second model. I am not entirely sure if I showed it off, but if I didn't, well, here you go. If I did, well, here you go again. So, let's do it. Alright, the equipment, the weapon. We have an Imperial Sword at level 6. The items, I'm definitely going to swap out the Peacock Urn for the Way of Musou. I think you already know why. But anyway, the bodyguards are at 8. The objectives are the same. We have to defeat Dong Zhuo. And we can't allow Yuan Shao to fall, or me to get killed. Well, if the time runs out, any of those three were fucked. Anyway, the unit info is the same, somewhat. For the allied forces, you have Yuan Shao, Yang Liang, and Wen Chou. Yuan Shu, Gan Sun San, Cao Cao, and Dian Wei. Sun Jian and Lu Xun, and Liu Bei and Zhuge Liang. For Dong Zhuo's forces, you have Dong Zhuo, Nao Fu, Huan Chou, and Wang Fang. Li Ru and Shu Rong, Li Dui and Jia Shu, Guo Se and Li Meng, Diao Chan, Dong Min, and Gao Shun. Alright, let's do it. And same thing, same objective, shit ton of KOs, shit ton of points, and we gotta be fucking quick with it. So, anyway.
can always get provisions from Sishui Gate. Do not hold back! Punish these traitors to the Han!
Did you think you could break through our forces? Our forces will march west. We head for Hulao Gate!
Alright, so we're gonna go and defeat Gao Shun first. And he's down.
Your overconfidence will be your downfall. Archers ready. Shoot all enemies down.
Enemy officer defeated.
Alright, now I'm gonna go and defeat Dongmin. And I'm pretty sure I said it already, like 5 or 6 times, but I'll say it again. If you are playing this stage for the first time, Zhang Liao will be here. Once you unlock Zhang Liao, however, Dongmin will be here instead. Blech. Anyway, so we're gonna go and defeat Dongmin and then take it from there. Healing one went awesome. And Dongmin is down. Now we're gonna go to the left. Well, my left, the map right, technically speaking. And defeat Li Meng and Guo Xia. And Guo Xia is right there, but I'm gonna go for Li Meng because obviously, if you defeat Guo Xia, Li Meng is actually serving, well, not serving, but is under Guo Xia's unit and will retreat if I defeat Guo Xia first. What the actual fuck? Yeah, fuck it. And he blocked it like a fucking fortress, of course. Anyway, I'm not that concerned because he's down now. Alright, now Li Ru and Shu Rong, and then we'll just wait. Well, that is if the gate doesn't get demolished by the time I defeat them both, but if I defeat Shu Rong and Li Ru, and the gate hasn't fallen yet, Hulao Gate, then I'll just wait it out until it actually falls. But for now, we'll just defeat Shu Rong and Li Ru and take it from there. Shu Rong is down. Now Li Ru. What the fuck? Did I even press the button? Well, anyway, Li Ru's down. And now we're just gonna have to wait it out for a bit. Well, never mind. So now Hulao Gate falls and obviously Lu Bu will appear. I'll let you know right now. For anyone that hasn't played Dynasty Warriors before and is going to be playing it for the first time, when you face Lu Bu, be very careful. He is very fucking strong. I'll tell you that right now. I mean, I'm pretty sure. Wow, he's... Okay, there you go. I was going to say, what the fuck?
Is that who I think it is? It's Lu Bu! Lu Bu's come to destroy us!
Alright, before I even approach him, because I know he's going to duel me, I want to see Liu Bei's rank and see if I can actually toss the duel without having my ally's morale drop. But it seems like I can, so I'll be fine.
You dare face the mighty Lu Bu? Know that I fight with the blade of virtue!
Yeah, I'm gonna toss it and just run around in a fucking circle the entire time because I know I won't be able to defeat Lu Bu in a duel, let alone attack him properly. Because, in some cases, if your attack is lower than a certain character's defense, depending on that type of character, they won't be able to flinch. I mean, they won't even flinch when he fucking attacked, and he got lucky with that fucking attack. I don't know how the fuck he reached me there. But, seems like I have to do a little bit more jumping. But anyway. Holy shit. Yeah, not happening. But anyway. Yeah, as I was saying, if your attack is that low in comparison to your enemy's defense, they won't even flinch when they attack you. In some cases, your Musou attacks, they won't even flinch there. So, the best scenario... Oh, wait, what the fuck? I thought it was... Well, you learn something new every day. It is at rank 8, so I don't know... Maybe for the fact that I'm actually close to rank 7? I don't know. Because every time, it's usually rank 7 or higher. Well, I'm not that concerned. Not going to be a big deal anyway. So...
You think you could break through our forces?
I'll just defeat Lubu anyway. And... I'm going to lure him over here, because there's an Imperial Seal here, and that'll help. That is if he doesn't run away. There you go. Awesome. Alright. Not too shabby. Now I just gotta be careful for Lubu actually killing me. And I think I fucked up there. No, I didn't. Alright, now I'm grabbing that healing ointment. And here we go again. In this case, he'll actually flinch. And he'll be on his 2 feet. But in some cases, in other games, I know with Dynasty Warriors 3... I can't even say Dynasty Warriors 3, but, their true Musou attack sometimes will either be that, or they'll be linked up in the air. I personally prefer them being on their 2 feet, like you saw there with Lubu, because, it'll be kind of easy to get a good couple attacks in. But at the same time, if he's linked up in the air, then my attacks will actually will be able to make him flinch. I'm not gonna even try to show you right here. I just know that it's gonna happen. If I try to attack him head on, then he won't even move. So and Lubu's over there. There you go. That's fine. I could go back and grab that. There you go. I'll grab that and do it again. Nice try. Yeah, I can get 5 or 6 attacks in before he actually blocks up. Just because of the Musou attack in general. But Liu Bei's Musou attack anyway. And I think I fucked that one up. Yeah, I kind of fucked that one up. I got a hit on him, but one isn't enough. And I fucked that one up. Yeah, let's back away. That was fucking close. Alright, there we go again. And I think I fucked that one up too. Yeah, I did. Yeah, let's go and grab some health. Because, if he does that one charge attack on me, I'm fucked. Plain and simple. So, we got that. I might as well secure the gates. And there's Lubu again. And I gotta make sure I keep an eye on him. Fuck. There you go. Alright. Yeah, you see, he's taking damage, but and I don't know why I decided to go at him without a full Musou gauge. Perfect. I could do that, and then grab that, and do it again. And I think he'll fall now. I think. No. There we go. He's down. So yeah, he could be a pain to deal with, but if you know how to defeat him, then it'll be really easy, obviously. I mean, there's two tricks I usually do with Lubu. Either one, equip the way of Musou, which makes things easier. All you have to do is fill up the Musou gauge. And second, if you don't have the Musou gauge, if you don't have the way of Musou, then simply just get your health all the way down to red, and you automatically will get true Musou. Every time. All you gotta do is not make sure. Well, all you have to do is make sure that you don't replenish your health. And DL Chan is down.
Let us meet again.
So in the current situation, I know I'm kind of going over the basics a little bit here, but I hope that's health. Yes, it is. All right, cool. But when I was in the I can't even say it now because I got health back. But in that situation where I had very little health, every Musou attack I do from there on, as long as I don't get any more health or get out of the red bar, so to speak, all my Musou attacks will be true Musou, which is more effective.
As long as my dream comes to fruition, I can sacrifice a capital city, or two, or three.
But anyway, I'm gonna go now and defeat Wang Fong. And now Yuan Shao is going to come out. And for the fact that we played the Battle of Si Shui Gate, Hua Xiang will not appear, and Deng Zhuo will actually retreat a lot sooner than you would think. I'm going to try to be quick and defeat the others. Or not. But he has a bit of distance for him to actually retreat. Hard to believe, but yeah. Anyway. Yeah, for some reason, it's very easy for Deng Zhuo to retreat. And you'll be lucky to actually get him. So I'm not worried about Deng Zhuo. I'm just going to try to get as much KOs as I possibly can. I mean, the only way you could get out of that is if you stall against Lubu for a set period of time, and I believe it's 20 minutes, then he'll actually set the forces to attack, and that's the only real way to prevent Deng Zhuo from retreating, I believe. And there he goes. And that's a win. Again. Alright, so KOs, not as much as I wanted to. Time, less than 15 minutes, which is good. 11 minutes and 10 seconds. Points, we'll just have to wait and see. So, no items, unfortunately. Like I said, 161 KOs, where the opponent count is 11. Could have possibly made it 12, but I didn't get to Fan Chou in time. And we have a good... Wow. ...6,939 points. Okay, there we go. Alright. And that's more enough to get the levels... Well, not level. Rank 7. Maybe we'll get a level 7 weapon. But, And now, rank 6. And we can equip a 4th item to Liu Bei. And we unlock his 3rd and 4th models. Now, the weapon experience. 2,746 points. More than enough to get to level 7. And his class 3 weapon, the Gold Dragon. Anyway. Bodyguards. They're at max, so it doesn't really matter. We will save. And there you have it. You've been watching my gaming adventures, and I'll see you in the next part, where we'll take on the next act and play all 3 stages to get one step closer to unlocking the 4th ending. But anyway, peace out.